Hey there everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to shave your natural nails like a boss. Maybe you're at home and you're wondering like, okay, how do I shave my nails so that they all look uniform, even, they're all kind of doing the same thing and all of that. So I'm going to go over some basics in this video. Probably see us pros here on YouTube use these kind of like gritty, thicker board files. These can tend to be a little bit grittier and not suitable for the natural nail. So ideally what you want to use is about a 180 grit emery board, and that looks like this, right? You can get this at a little, not a grocery store, a pharmacy store, right? These are nice. They have a nice grit to the nail. So again, to file your nails, your natural nails, you need something that's not so gritty. So the first thing you want to do when filing your nails is to take a long look, like get a visual on what your natural nails already do. Now you may want something that is not natural to your nails, something that your natural nails aren't already doing, but take a look, see what they're doing, and then work with what you have. I think that is my best advice I can give you so that you can find the shape or give yourself the shape that is going to accent your fingers. Okay, so in my case, my nails can tend to fan out a little bit without any enhancements, like if I'm not wearing product on it. So what I want to do in this case is to actually reference my cuticle area point here, right? And that's going to determine how I'm going to shape the free edge of my nails. Again, you might like short and square, totally cool. And I don't, because I just feel like it doesn't give my nails like a long, narrow, slender look. So here's what I do. I use the cuticle area as a reference to kind of match the width of the free edge. So in, for example, in this case, this free edge is wider than my cuticle area, so it's not going to give me like a long, narrow, slender nail bed look. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to very gently in one direction take my board file and file the edges on most of my nails to make them slender. Now professionally we don't advise this because we don't want this to take strength from your natural nail. If you file a lot at the sidewalls, it will diminish the strength, and if you saw back and forth, you are also going to create splitting on those sidewalls and you're going to have those annoying side tear bends. So don't do that. Work with a smooth, gentle file and file in one direction. Now, if I wanted these to be square, I can still have them be straight and still narrow looking just by taking a little bit of the sidewall there. Again, in the professional field, especially like if you're in a nail competition or something, this is not desirable to take out of the free edge. But I've met many a client who just always wants a more narrow looking nail bed, okay? No one likes natural, fanned out, wide nail beds. They're just not cute. They don't look uniform, okay? So I'm gonna give myself the roundness of my cuticle area. I'm gonna put that here so that it can look slender, nice, and again accent my fingers, because I think my fingers can be, maybe you can't tell here, but they're a little bit more chubby, and I want my nails, my hands, pardon, to look narrow. Okay, so with that tip, I'm just gonna go ahead and in one direction take in the sidewalls to the approximate like corner of my cuticle. I'm gonna imagine that my cuticle has a corner, so I want it to be about there. I can go under, just be gentle. The idea is to be gentle. And this is going to take a little bit of time. When you saw back and forth, yes, you're going to diminish the length rather quickly, but that's not what you want to do. It's your natural nail. They can break if you don't treat them nice at this point. Okay, so you see, obviously, I'm off a little bit. I can go ahead and clip them, but clip them can cause splitting. So I'm just going to try to use file. Unless you have an excessive length that you want to cut short, then obviously cut. But I would recommend to just always, as much as possible, if you're trying to grow out your nails long and strong, then just to stick to filing. And you can file them weekly or two times a week. This is going to encourage and promote nail growth also. Now, this is a very important step here. I know a lot of people ask themselves this and kind of they don't get the answer. It's like how to measure these nails, like which one should be longer, which one should be shorter. Very good question. So naturally, a lot of the times your pointer finger, this one, will grow much faster than the rest. So it's up to you if you want to go shorter just automatically on them. Professionally, what I do is I do the same, a little bit longer and just a little bit shorter on this. So this one, this length will never match this length, okay? Or any of these lengths. The reason why you will go a little bit longer on your middle finger is because your middle finger is usually a little bit wider, and a wider nail is going to look shorter. So we want to create the illusion that this nail is narrow by extending it or letting it like just 1 millimeter or two a little bit longer, okay? Now, if all of your nails are narrow and they're not fanned out, like my middle one, you can see it's a little bit more fanned out, then you can keep them, these three, all the same length if you want, and then just this one a little shorter. So again, shorter, 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 shorter. This one stays a little bit longer, okay? So then you measure from cuticle area to free edge. So you can see that naturally this is shorter for me. I don't know if you can see it there. So I want to go way shorter on this one. Now, if you have something more coarse, then just for like time's sake, you can just go one direction to shorten it. Again, the grittier it is, the more it'll shorten. I still wouldn't solve back and forth because you're gonna create some splitting. So this one needs to go way short, okay? See, now from cuticle, I'm measuring from cuticle to free edge. And now these two, you can do it with clients, that this one matches this one. This one's a little bit longer, and that's totally fine. I'm just gonna take it a tiny bit down, but still make it longer. And then on our pinky, we are going to go just a tad bit shorter, because naturally it already runs small. Definitely do not allow the pinky nail to be your longest nail. And now I'm gonna go back to my emery board because I just used my coarse file to shorten the nails. And I'm gonna go, I wanna match the corner of my cuticle area to the corners on my nail so that I have a nice long slender nail. I could just file like this, but you'll notice that my free edge is going to be wider than my cuticle area. If you're going for more of a slender look, then I would definitely recommend taking the sides. If you don't feel comfortable, or you don't need to, or you don't want to, it's not your thing, it's not what you're going for, then you don't have to. But personally, so many clients do it, and if I can just teach you how to do it right, if you're still gonna do it and be stubborn about it, then you know I've done my job. So again, one direction. Now I'm gonna go ahead and marry my entire nail look here. So I've already done my thumb. All right, so here we are now, just about done. What I'm gonna do now is take a little bit of alcohol so I can clean my nail and get like a good visual on what we have right now. Okay, this is how we're looking, very nice and neat. Now, if you have a spatula tool, this is a good step to kind of come in here and go in underneath your nail to just get rid of those frills there, and then go this way, this way. And now you can take either your buffer or your emery board. That's totally fine. And be very gentle if you're using your emery board to just file the edges here. I'll link you to some of these better quality professional files in the description box. These are from Leaf Gel. I think I have a little code PPN15 you can use. So those are quality. They'll last you like, I'm not kidding you, like a whole year. They're very good. We have beautiful, uniformly shaped natural nails. We'll see you next week with a new video. Let me know what you think.